Listen, I'm incredibly proud of my achievements as an individual. More so, the stuff that we've achieved, the Four Ashes series, the World Cup. There's some brilliant stuff that's gone on in my career. But to ask me how good I am, I don't know. Other people can talk about my cricketing numbers, I suppose.
History will talk about your cricketing numbers. And then
yeah,
it will say...
Yeah, they might, do some good stuff and some bad stuff.
Yeah, but then it will say, he stopped. And
he was sacked, yeah. It was cut short, unfortunately.
And that therefore, in a sense, you underachieved?
Maybe I've underachieved. I think I've overachieved. I came to England 15 years ago as a little off-spinner who didn't know how to bat, or sort of knew how to bat. And I've ended up playing 104 test matches, and we've got Ashes series home and away. We've got a World Cup. We've beaten India for the first time in 20-odd years. It's been a brilliant journey. So I think I've overachieved, not underachieved.
Let me just talk to you a bit about character. I mean, can it really be that such an array of people as you name in your book, Jimmy Anderson, Andy Flower, Andrew Strauss, Peter Moores, Matt Prior, can they all be wrong and you be the one that's right?
I think we've all got issues in terms of our makeups. Everybody as a human being has got issues. We've all got our faults. I've talked about this as my story, my side of the story. I don't really say that Jimmy Anderson's a horrible person at all. I say that he's a fantastic guy, so I wouldn't include him in that list. I had my differences with some other people. Clearly, I had my differences because my thought pattern was different to theirs. And some people didn't like my hard questioning on direction of the team and what we should be doing instead of doing other things. My character's been assassinated for 5 or 6 years since the captaincy got taken away from me. There's been a huge ECB machine that's worked against me in terms of the PR. And it's now my side to put things right and to have the truth out there, and then people can make their opinions. And I don't think it's going to be bad.
Do you think the ECB will ever do anything about the bullying that you allege? And I mean, you know what's funny? We're looking at a very strong man, a man with an amazing cricketing record, one of the greatest batsmen that England has ever seen, and you talk about being bullied.
No, I talk about myself being bullied in the Twitter parody account that was set up. I don't talk about myself being bullied in the dressing room.
No, but it was set up, as you know, by two or three England players, wasn't it?
Of course it was, yes. And that's what basically ruined everything for me and just took everything away from my feeling of trust and my respect in terms of the team. And it hurt me severely. And I was in tears in Andy Flower's room in Headingley during a test match saying, how can we come to this? How has this happened?
Isn't there a danger it was just an English sense of humour?
I wouldn't say it's a sense of humour when you publicly humiliate one of your teammates. I don't think that there's anything sense of humour about that, no.
How real is your commitment to England? You still got that tattoo? You had that Three Lions tattoo? You haven't got rid of it?
Yeah, no, she's still there, and I'm incredibly proud of it. And I wear this with pride because there's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears that have gone into this. Not let alone when it was put in on my arm. but it's an amazing badge that I wear with great amount of pride and honour.
Kevin, finally, I mean, just I'm holding the book in my hand. I'm looking. It's a fine looking tome. I've not read all of it, but I've read a bit of it. But Graham Swan, who claims to have read most of it, says it's a work of fiction, akin to something written by Jules Verne.
The key to his defence right there is to try and make a laughing joke out of something that's quite serious. I can go to sleep tonight knowing that everything I've written in that book is true.
And was he one of the bullies that forced you out, would you say?
Oh, he was definitely one of the... He was in that clique, yeah, definitely.
Kevin Pietersen, thank you very much indeed for talking with us.
Thanks, John. Appreciate it.